Okay, we will discuss heat transfer.
We will discuss analysis of a dual cycle. In the previous lecture videos, we have discussed analysis of Otto cycle and diesel cycle and Carnot cycle. Okay, now we will discuss heat transfer in a dual cycle. A dual cycle will be like this. It consists of 5 processes. It is a cyclic process. It consists of 5 processes. On a PV diagram, if we draw a dual cycle on a PV diagram, it will be an isentropic compression. A dual cycle, it is called as a dual cycle, means in a Otto cycle, heat is added at constant volume. In a diesel cycle, heat is added at constant pressure. But in a dual cycle, as the name suggests, a portion of heat is added at constant volume and a portion of heat is added at constant pressure. Heat is added at constant volume as well as at constant pressure. The other processes will be the same, that is isentropic processes. Okay. And heat is rejected at constant value. Okay, here 1 to 2 is isentropic compression process. Okay, 2 to 3, it is a theoretical cycle. These are what we are discussing now, air standard cycle. These are theoretical cycles. Okay, 1 to 2 is isentropic compression. 2 to 3 is constant volume heat addition. In a dual cycle concept, a portion of heat is added at constant volume and a portion of heat is added at constant pressure. And 3 to 4 is again constant pressure process. It is a horizontal line. 3 to 4 is constant pressure heat addition. 2 to 3 is constant volume heat addition. And 4 to 1 is isentropic expansion. 4 to 5. And 5 to 1 is constant value heat rejection. Constant value heat rejection. Okay. Here there are two heat addition processes. There are two heat addition processes. This is 2 to 3. QS is added. A portion of heat is added during the process 2 to 3. I will call it as QS1. And a portion of heat is added at constant pressure, that is during the process 3 to 4, I will call it as QS2. Okay, and heat is rejected at QR during the process 5 to 1, heat is rejected. Okay, this is a PV diagram for a dual cycle. This is a PV diagram for a dual cycle. Okay, if I draw its TS diagram, temperature entropy diagram. Okay, if I draw its temperature entropy diagram. Okay, it will be like this. 1 to 2 is isentropic process. Isentropic process is nothing but a reversible adiabatic, means entropy remains constant. Okay, 1 to 2 isentropic process, entropy remains constant. Okay, 2 to 3 is constant volume process. It will be like this. 2 to 3, a constant volume process. 2 to 3. Okay, and write with other color. Okay, so that it may be it is properly visible. 2 to 3. Okay, 2 to 3 is constant volume process. Okay, P equal to C. Here what I want to tell is, I will draw it once again because I want to clarify something, that is this is P equal to C, constant volume process. Okay, 2 to 3, it is followed by constant pressure process. Constant pressure process. Okay, 3 to, it is again 3 to 4 constant pressure process. Okay, P equal to C. Okay, there is a slight difference between a constant volume process and a constant pressure process on a TS diagram. Okay, that is what I want to tell. If on a TS diagram, you should know how to draw a constant volume process and a constant pressure process on a TS diagram. Okay. starting from the same initial point 1, okay, if you write a constant volume heat addition, this is a P equal to C, constant volume heat addition process, this is 2 to 1 to 2, 1 to 2 dash, okay, P equal to C, P equal to C, this is a constant pressure heat addition process, this is a constant volume heat addition process. By these two processes, these two lines, we can see that the slope of a constant volume process is more compared to constant pressure process. Means constant volume process is more steeper on a TS diagram compared to constant pressure process. That is the difference between a constant pressure line and a constant volume line on a TS diagram. Okay. Now, 4 to 5 is constant volume heat rejection, 5 to 1 is constant isentropic process, sorry, constant, 4 to 5 is isentropic expansion, 5 to 1 is isentropic, 5 to 1 is constant volume heat rejection, okay. This is a PV and TS diagram, PV and TS diagram for a dual cycle, okay. Now we will write what is the work done, what is heat transfer during these individual processes, okay. We will write that, what is the work done during process 1 to 2, during process 1 to 2, process 1 to 2, 1 to 2 is which type of process, 1 to 2 is a adiabatic process or isentropic process, okay. 1 to 2 is adiabatic process, adiabatic process, okay, classification, which type of process it is, okay. Therefore, work done, I will write heat transfer and work done. Heat transfer, heat transfer, work done, work done, okay. Heat transfer and work done. Work done in the process 1 to 2. How to calculate? Or heat transfer initially. 1 to 2 is an isentropic process or an adiabatic process. A reversible adiabatic process is called as isentropic process. Okay. Therefore, there is no heat transfer in the isentropic process. Work done, we can write it as P1, P1 minus P2, P2 divided by gamma minus 1. It is correct. Okay. But from first law of thermodynamics, Q is equal to W plus delta U. Okay. As Q is equal to 0, Q is equal to 0 because heat transfer equal to 0. This law obeys for all the processes. Okay. This law process 1 to 2 ko obey atare. This law is true for process 1 to 2 as well as this law is true for process 2 to 3 as well as this is true for 3 to 4, 4 to 5 and 5 to 1. Because it is the first law of thermodynamics, it should obey. Okay. Therefore, we can write Q1 to 2 is equal to W1 to 2 plus delta U. Delta U is nothing but U2 minus U1. Okay. U2 minus U1. Therefore, we can write W1 to 2, W1 to 2, that is work done during this process, we can write U2 minus U1. U2 minus U1. Like this, we can write the U is equal to U2 minus U1. Therefore, work done, I can write this U2 minus U1 is nothing but change in internal energy. Change in internal energy is Cv delta T. Change in enthalpy is Cp delta T. Okay. Therefore, it will be Cv T2 minus T1. Okay. This is true if it is, this is correct. Okay. This is Cv T2. But I will write here 1 to 2 is a compression work. Work is done on the system. Work is done on the system, therefore what I will write, minus Cv T2 minus T1, or this is equal to Cv into T1 minus T2. What if 5 I have written minus Cv T2 minus T1, it should be Cv T2 minus T1, but it is a compression work, therefore it is done on the system, work done on the system is taken as negative, work done by the system is taken as positive, therefore I will write it as minus Cv T2 minus T1. Okay. This is one thing. Okay. Now, next, process 2 to 3. Process 2 to 3. process 2 to 3. 2 to 3 is 2 to 3 is constant volume process. 2 to 3 it is V equal to 3, constant volume process. Heat transfer during a process 2 to 3. Heat transfer during the process 2 to 3. We know again work done during the process 2 to 3 is equal to 0. Therefore, heat transfer is equal to change in internal energy. Internal energies. Therefore, it will be Cv into T3 minus T2. Okay. Because for the process 2 to 3, we can write Q2 to 3 is equal to W2 to 3 plus delta U. Okay. Q2 to 3 is equal to delta U. That delta U is nothing but Cv T3 minus T2. Okay. Like this, it will be Cv T3 minus T2. Okay. Now, for the process 3 to 4, work done during the process 2 to 3 is 0. Work done during the process 2 to 3 is 0. Why? Because it is a constant volume process. Okay. Now, for process 3 to 4, 3 to 4 is a constant pressure process, P equal to C. Constant pressure process, heat transfer during the process 3 to 4. Heat transfer during the process 3 to 4. We can write it as again Q3 to 4. We can write for the process 3 to 4 also. We can write like this. That is, for the process 3 to 4, we can write Q3 to 4 equal to W3 to 4 plus delta U. Okay, or U4 minus U3. U4 minus U3. Okay. Therefore, what I can write? Q3 to 4. We have to calculate. W3 to 4 is nothing but, what is W3 to 4? P3 V3 minus P4 V4. Okay. Plus U4 minus, U4. Actually, it will be P4 V4 minus P3 V3. P into V2 minus V1. It should be. Work done in a constant pressure process is equal to P4 V4 minus P3 V3. Okay. Plus U4 minus U3. Okay. This one I can rearrange. P4 V4 plus U4 plus U4 minus of P3 V3 plus U3. Okay. This summation of internal energy plus product of pressure and volume, we can write it as enthalpy. Therefore, we can write it as H4 minus H3. Okay. Therefore, it is H4 minus H3. Therefore, we can write it as Cp T4 minus T3. Cp, because change in enthalpy is Cp delta T. Change in internal energy is Cv delta T. Work done during the process 3 to 4. We can write like this. P3 V3 as well as if I write Pv equal to RT, I can write R into T4 minus T3. T4 minus T3. Okay. From ideal gas equation, I can write Pv equal to RT. Okay. Now, for the process, next process, for the process 4 to 5. Okay. For the process 4 to 5, it is isentropic expansion 4 to 5. Isentropic expansion, adiabatic process it is. Adiabatic process, heat transfer is equal to 0. Work done again, Cv, final temperature minus initial temperature. Okay. Cv, final temperature minus initial temperature. Therefore, it will be Cv T4 minus T5. Okay. Cv T4 minus T5. Okay. It will be in the similar way. Itarane even calculation madadra. If you do the same calculation here, Cv into T4 minus T5. Okay. Cv into T4 minus T5. And again, for the process 5 to 1. 5 to 1 is constant volume heat rejection, P equal to C. Okay, heat transfer can be given in the constant volume process as Cv delta T. You remember one thing, heat transfer in a constant pressure process is Cp delta T. Heat transfer in a constant volume process is Cv delta T. Okay, therefore Cv T5 minus T1. Okay, or we can write minus Cv because it is heat rejected, or we can write minus Cv T1 minus T5, both are same. Okay, now work done during this process is zero. Now we will utilize these work done and heat transfer to calculate efficiency and mean effective pressure. We will calculate efficiency and mean effective pressure. Okay, first I will calculate efficiency. Okay, we will calculate efficiency in a dual cycle. Efficiency. In general, efficiency is equal to output by input. Efficiency equal to, it is denoted by eta, it is equal to output by input. What is the output here? It is work done during the cyclic process. I will drop this TS diagram, but while deriving efficiency of dual cycle or any cycle or anything in the applied thermodynamics, you have to draw PV diagram. Okay, if necessary you draw TS diagram also. Okay, because it doesn't mean anything if you don't write it, the PV diagram. If you derive completely correctly, you may get 0 marks because it doesn't mean anything. If you write T1 without drawing its PV diagram, it doesn't mean anything. Okay, output is nothing but work done or net work done, we can write net work done. Okay, input is heat supplied, that is input. Okay, now we will calculate what is the heat supplied, that is QS. I will write W net divided by QS. Okay, heat supplied is equal to QS1 plus QS2. Heat supplied is equal to QS1 plus QS2, that is heat supplied during the process 2 to 3 plus heat supplied during the process 3 to 4, that is the total heat supplied. Okay, how will you write QS1? Just now we have derived expression for heat transfer. Okay, QS1 is nothing but Cv, the heat transfer in the constant. I will write QS equal to, it is a constant volume process. Heat transfer in a constant volume process is equal to Cv delta T. Cv T3 minus T2. Okay. Heat transfer during the process 3 to 4 is equal to, in a constant pressure process is equal to Cp T4 minus T2. T4 minus T3. Cp, it is heat transfer in a constant pressure process is equal to Cp delta T. Heat transfer in a constant volume process is equal to Cv delta T. Okay, that you have to remember. Now, net work done. We have net work done is nothing but work done during the process 1 to 2, W1 to 2 plus W2 to 3, there is no work. Okay, because it is a constant volume process. Therefore, W3 to 4, I will not W2 to 3 because 2 to 3 is a constant volume process. Work done in a constant volume process is 0, and work done during the process 4 to 5, W4 to 5 plus W5 to 1 is again 0. Why? Because 5 to 1 is again constant volume process. Okay, here again this is a negative work. W1 to 2 is a negative work. Therefore, what I will write? Minus Cv. Okay, this I will write minus Cv. It is a negative work. Therefore, I am writing it as, because it is a compression work. Work done on the system is taken as negative. Therefore, minus Cv into T2 minus T1. Okay. W3 to 4. Work done in a constant pressure process is equal to Cp T4 minus T3. Okay. W4 to 5 just now we have derived that. Okay. Sorry, W 3 to 4 is a constant pressure process, no? Work W 3 to 4, work done equal to R T4 minus T3. It is not Cp, it is R. Just now we have derived that. R T4 minus T3 is W 3 to 4 plus W 4, 5, 4 to 5 is equal to work done during the process 4 to 5 is equal to Cv T4 minus T5. Cv T4 minus T5. Okay. This is work done. This is heat supplied. Work done divided by heat supplied. We will get efficiency. We'll get the expression for efficiency. But we will still simplify here. We'll still simplify some things here. Okay. What we will do is we know Cp minus Cv is equal to R. We know this one. Cp minus Cv equal to R. Therefore, Cp minus Cv equal to R. Okay. Here, instead of writing R, I will substitute Cp minus Cv. Okay, what will happen? We will see. W net equal to minus Cv into T2 minus T1. I will simplify only. I will make one more step. T2 minus T1 plus R badli en barthindre Cp minus Cv into T4 minus T3 plus Cv into T4 minus T5. Okay. T4 minus T5. Okay. It is equal to, I will multiply here, minus Cv into, I will multiply into T2 plus Cv into T1. Okay. I will multiply here plus Cp into T4 minus Cp into T3 minus Cv into T4. Okay, this one here plus Cv into T3 plus Cv into T4 minus Cv into T5. Okay, now some things will cancel. Okay, Cv T3, is there any Cv T3? Okay, Cv T2 is there or Cv T4 is there? This is negative. Where is Cv T4? This is positive Cv T4. They will cancel. Okay. And now I will make Cp on one side and Cv on other side. Okay. Cp on one side and Cv on other side. Okay. Therefore, Cp into, what will remain same? Cp is for this. Cp into T3 minus, Cp into T, Cp I will take common, T4 minus T3. Cp into T4 minus T3. Okay. And I will simplify plus Cv into okay, Cv into T3 minus T2. T3 minus T2. Okay. Plus Cv into T3 minus T2. Minus Cv into T5 minus T2. Minus Cv into T5 minus T1. Okay. Means there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 term. Here also you will be having 6 term. Okay. This is W net. Okay. Now if we substitute here, if we substitute, I will check whether we have missed something. Cv T3 minus T2. Okay. Correct. Now, I will substitute in this equation. Heat supplied I will substitute, as well as I will substitute this one. Okay, we'll check what happens. We'll substitute net work done and heat supplied in this equation. Okay, I will rub this.
therefore efficiency will be equal to okay,
work done. Just now we have done Cp T4 minus T3.
Cp T4 minus T3 plus Cv T3 minus T2. Just now we have derived this one now. Cv T3 minus T2 minus Cv T5 minus T1. T5 minus T1 divided by heat supplied. Heat supplied we have derived Cp T4 minus T3 plus Cv T3 minus T2. Cp T4 minus T3 plus Cv T3 minus T2. Okay. Now we will simplify this one. Okay, we will simplify this one. Okay, here we can simplify like this one. We can divide this one. Divide this one like this. 1 minus 1 minus Cv T5 minus T1. Okay, we can rearrange this like this. The same equation I can rearrange. 1 minus Cv T5 minus T1 divided by Cp T4 minus T3. That is nothing but 1 minus QR divided by QS into Cv into T3 minus T2. Okay. This is QR, this is QS. 1 minus QR by QS. Like that we have rearranged it. Now, what we need? We need to express it in terms of compression ratio, pressure ratio and cutoff ratio. Here three terms will be there. Therefore, we will still rearrange it. Okay. Here in the numerator there is Cv, in the denominator there is Cp. Therefore, what I will do, we will divide it by Cv. We will divide it by Cv or we will rearrange like this. Efficiency equal to 1 minus T5 minus T1 divided by Cp by Cv into T4 minus T3 plus T3 minus T2. Okay. Therefore, it will be 1 minus T5 minus T1 divided by Cp by Cv is gamma. Gamma into T4 minus T3 plus T3 minus T2. Okay. Now, this is the expression for efficiency, but it is in terms of temperature. We will express this one in terms of pressure ratio and compression ratio in terms of non-dimensional parameters. Okay. We will express this. That we'll do now. Okay. To do that, what we will do is we will express T2, T3. Previously we have done, we have expressed T2, T3 and T4 in terms of T1. Here we will do in some different manner, because if we substitute in terms of T1, we will go on solving, will not get. It is better to substitute T1, T2, T4 and T5 in terms of T1. We will substitute all other temperatures in terms of T3, not T1, in terms of T3. Okay. Now, what we will do, this only expression I will leave. Okay. What we will do is, okay. Now, I will call this one as equation number 1. Equation number 1. Okay. Now we will define some terms. Only we know that V2 by V1, V1 by V2, V1 by V2 is equal to what? Compression ratio RC. Compression ratio
compression ratio RC is P1 by P2. Okay. And P4 by P3. P4 by P3 is equal to cutoff ratio. Cutoff ratio R. Okay. And we will define one more term. P3 by P2 is pressure ratio RP. Okay, we'll define this term. Okay, now we will express. Okay, what is compression ratio? Compression ratio is the volume before compression to volume after compression, P1 by P2. And pressure ratio is pressure after heat addition to pressure before heat addition. Cutoff ratio is volume after heat addition to volume before heat addition. Okay. These are the three terms which you should know. Okay. Now, we will express this efficiency in terms of those compression ratio, pressure ratio like that. Okay. We will express here. We'll substitute T1, T2, T4 and T5, T1, T2, T4 and T5 in terms of T3. Okay, we'll substitute T1, T2, T4 and T5 in terms of T3. That we'll do. Okay, how to do that? We'll do like this one. First we'll calculate for the process 4 to 5, for process in equation 1, okay, for process 4 to 5, okay, what is T4 by T5 equal to? T4 by T5 equal to, for process 4 to 5, T4 by T5 equal to P5 by P4 raised to gamma minus 1. Okay, what I'll do, I will divide and multiply by P3 here, therefore it will be P5 divided by P3 into P3 by P4 raised to gamma minus 1. Okay, what is P5 by P3? This is P5 by P3 is nothing but, what is P5 by? We can write like this, P5 is equal to what? P5 equal to P1, this one, because 5 to 1 is a constant volume process, and P3 equal to P2. Therefore, we can write P5 by P3 as RC. Okay. Therefore, and P3 by P2. P3 by P2, P4 equal to what? P3 by P4. P3 by P4 is equal to 1 divided by R, that is cutoff ratio, just now we heard it. Therefore, it will be RC raised to RC divided by R raised to gamma minus 1. RC divided by R raised to gamma minus 1, that is from the process 4 to 5. Okay, from process 4 to 5. Now, for the process, what we are doing, we want to calculate all in terms of T3, that is our aim. Okay, now what we will do for process 1 to 2, okay, what is T2 by T1? For process 1 to 2 is T2 by T1 equal to RC raised to P1 by P2 raised to gamma minus 1, P1 by P2 raised to gamma minus 1. This P1 by P2 is nothing but RC raised to gamma minus 1. Okay. Now, we will calculate we know T2. Okay, now T2 by T1 is equal to this. Okay, let us call this as equation number 1. I'll call it as equation number 1. Let us call this as equation number 2. Okay, let us call this as equation number 2. Now for the process 2 to 3. For process 2 to 3, PVT relation. Okay, it is a constant volume process. Therefore, T3 by T2 is equal to, okay, P3 by P2 is nothing but pressure after detection to pressure before detection. It is nothing but RP. Okay, RP. Okay, let us call it as equation. This one as 1 I have given now. This I will call it as small I or small 1, Roman 1. This is 2. This one is 3. Okay. This one is 3. Okay. Now, for the process 3 to 4. Okay. For process, I will write here because space is not there. I don't want to delete this because I want to substitute all other terms here. Therefore, I am writing like this. For process 3 to 4, what will be? 3 to 4 is constant pressure process. Therefore, P4 by P3 is nothing but R. Okay. Now, one more step. I have to rub this one only. Okay. Okay. Remember, this is equation number 1. That much you remember it. Okay. Let this be equation 4. Small Roman 4. Okay. This is equation 1. We will calculate T1, T2, T4, T5 in terms of T3 and we will substitute here. Okay. To do that, now for process 4 to 5. Okay. I am not rubbing this because they are necessary. Therefore, further also, therefore, I am not rubbing this. For process 4 to 5. 4 to 5 is isentropic expansion. Therefore, T5 we have just now calculated. Okay, therefore it is not necessary. Now, okay, what we have done is, we have already calculated T4 in terms of T3. What we are doing, we are calculating all in terms of T3. T4 equal to T3 into R. We have calculated T4 in terms of T3 here. Okay. We have calculated T2 also in terms of T3. T2 is equal to RP divided by T3. Now we have to calculate T5, okay, T5 and T1 in terms of T3, then we can substitute in efficiency equation, we will get the answer. Okay, now how to find T5 in terms of T3? Okay, now Therefore, T4 valiyan baribodrina T3 into R divided by T5 it is equal to RC divided by R raised to gamma minus 1. Okay. Therefore, T5 is equal to what? T5 equal to T5 you will get it as T3 into R raised to gamma minus 1 into R divided by RC raised to gamma minus 1. Okay. RC raised to gamma minus 1. Okay. Okay. Therefore, you will get it as you will get, we have got this one in terms of, or I can write like this also. T5 equal to T3 R into bracket R divided by RC raised to gamma minus 1. Okay, the same thing. I will rub what is this one, this unnecessary thing. I will rub this one. Okay. Now we got T5 in terms of T3, okay, T2 in terms of T3, T4 in terms of T3. What we have to do? T1, T2, T3, T4, T4 and T5 in terms of T3, okay. Now we need to calculate T1 in terms of T3. To do that, I will rub this one. I will rub this one first, okay. This is not necessary. Substituting. Now what I'll do, I will substitute equation 3 in equation 2. This is equation 2, this is equation 3. Substituting will T1 in terms of T3 bakery. Therefore, what I'll do, substituting equation, this is also not necessary, I will drop this. Okay. Equation 3 in equation 2. This equation 3, I will substitute in equation 2. Substituting equation 3, okay, in equation 2. Okay, I will substitute T2 badhiye en barthide, I need T1 in terms of T3. T2 badhiye RP divided by T3. Okay, into 1 by T1. It is equal to RC raised to gamma minus 1. RC raised to gamma minus 1. Okay. Now, therefore, T1 is equal to, T1 is equal to, the T1 is equal to RP divided by T3 into RC raised to gamma minus 1. Okay. We'll check it. Okay, correct. Now, we have calculated them. What we have calculated? We have calculated T2 in terms of T3, T4 in terms of T3, T5 in terms of T3, and T1 in terms of T3. Substituting T1, T2, T4 and T5 in equation 1. Okay. Substituting T1, comma T2, T4 and T5 in equation 1. Okay. What is our equation 1? It was efficiency is equal to. Efficiency, then we'll get efficiency equal to 1 minus, 1 minus, I'll write it. Okay. 1 minus. Actually it was 1 minus T5 minus T1, 1 minus T5 minus T1, right? No doubt, see that, okay, because there is no space, therefore I have rubbed that, 1 minus of T5, T5 is this one, right? T5 is equal to T3 into R divided by RC raised to gamma minus 1, okay, I will rub this one also. Because there is no space, therefore I have to do that one. Okay. T3, T3 will be in the numerator because we are substituting all values in the form of T3. Therefore, I think T3 will get cancelled. T3 will get cancelled. therefore I don't want to write T3 again. Okay, T3 will get cancelled because it will be, we are substituting all in terms of T3 in numerator as well as denominator, therefore they will get cancelled. Okay, therefore what you will get it as R into R raised to R divided by RC raised to gamma minus 1 minus, this is T5 minus T1 RP divided by RC raised to gamma minus 1. Okay, divided by it was gamma into T4 minus T3 plus T3 minus T2. Okay, therefore gamma into bracket T4 minus T3. T4 is this one. Okay, R minus T3 is 1. Okay, you check it. You substitute and calculate. Okay, T3 minus plus plus it will be CV into T3 minus T2. T3 minus T2. Okay. T3 minus T2. Actually, T2 should be equal to this one. T3 divided by